Stand-up comedian James Acaster.
Never baked before, let alone competitively, let alone on Bake Off. The worst idea anyone's ever had. It's absolutely ludicrous.
I'm
making Bakewell flapjacks.
Oh, lovely.
The texture of your flapjack
is
on
perfect.
The top, it looks a bit wet.
Oh, yeah, that's because it's not baked yet. I can explain this to you. Before it goes in the oven, it's often a lot soggier. And then you bake it and it then gets harder.
Yeah.
So don't you worry. When you eat it, it won't be like this.
It won't be soggy.
Right, OK.
Is the texture OK? Good joke.
Topped with a cream cheese icing and scattered with almonds, James is confident his Bakewell tart-inspired flapjacks will be no laughing matter.
Do you want to shake my hand now or later? Up to you. You can shake it now to save yourself the bother, or you can shake it later on and eat humble pie as well as these flapjacks. Come on, be magically done. The mixture is still liquid. This is meant to be encouraging people at home to get involved and bake for charity. It's the worst experience of my life.
A bit concerned about how it was going to bond together and bake.
Oh, I remember you saying that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you came out and you dropped some hints.
Yeah.
I thought you were throwing me some red herrings. I thought, I'm not going to fall for that.
Mm.
But it turned out you were double bluffing me. You knew this had happened.
I sort of did.
Very clever of you.
Let's have a look, shall we?
Let's have a look.
Bit of a small bit.
Yeah.
Up to him.
The reason why I cut the end bit is because actually where it's browned and caramelised with the butter, it's absolutely gorgeous.
Isn't
yeah, it is. Great flavour, not very well executed.
Story of my life.
You've made one horn and you're baking it standing up.
Yeah.
Where are the rest?
Oh, let's be realistic. I'm going to do a deconstructed cream horn. Nice and full. I'm just going to use these chocolate drops here as a dam.
That's our personal favourite.
Well, all the elements are here.
You mean the ingredients
we've
are there?
We've got the chocolates, we've got the orange. I don't think that's been in the... I think it may have been in the oven briefly, but it's all the butter's poured out of it.
You're right.
They've made scrambled egg.
All right.
I don't know what I can say about that.
Well,
I do like the artistic look.
No, you don't.
It's certainly not what we're looking for.
In fourth place, we have this one. Who is responsible for this? Well, all I can say is it does have the ingredients we gave you. There.
What more could you ask?
The bowl should be able to be tipped upside down without the mixture slipping. That's what people watch Bake Off for. That's confidence, isn't it?
Shouldn't really go in freehand, should I? But
would someone who plays by the book do this?
James' main attraction will be a meringue version of the park's famous roller coaster, adorned with a tuck shop's worth of retro sweets.
Thieves, a roller coaster bits.
Do you do all that?
I don't really ever do that. Do you do that?
Yeah, big face.
I'm one of those people who's emotionless. You know when you get the photo?
Yeah, and there's nothing happening. Wow, there's not much difference between that and you being judged for Bake Off.
No.
That's the same face.
Same amount of suppressed glee. Icing a raw egg. Does the name Prue mean anything to you? The roller coaster in meringue. It's sweet egg flavour.
Sweet egg.
Ah, now see if you can spot the secret ingredient in the water.
No is the answer.
I put loads of salt on it for a laugh.
You're right. There
quite
is.
Quite like it actually.
It's like salted caramel. That's true.
Your meringues are all a little bit underbaked. They're all a little bit soft. I'm surprised it stayed up, actually.
So am I.
Yes.
The idea is sound enough. I think it's brilliant, James.
Thank you very much, Paul. Thank you very much. What a showstopper. Paul kind of gave me a look during that showstopper that let me know, obviously we can't give it to you, but you are a star baker.